Hi, welcome back. Instead of one equation in a single variable, we may also consider two different equations in two variables. Let's consider the following example. We want to calculate the points of intersection of the line given by y equals x plus 1 and the circle with radius 5 whose center is at the origin. First, we need an equation that describes the circle. Note that the circle is not the graph of a function since there are two different points that have the same x-coordinate. The circle consists of all points x, y that have distance 5, the radius, to the origin. So by Pythagoras' theorem we have x squared plus y squared equals 5 squared, and this gives us an equation describing all points on the circle. So if x, y is an intersection point, then x and y satisfy the equations y equals x plus 1, that is, x, y is a point on the line, and also x squared plus y squared equals 25, that is, x, y is a point on the circle. We call such a set of equations in the same variables a system of equations. To solve this system of equations, we substitute the first equation into the second one. So we replace y in the second equation by x plus 1. This gives us an equation in which we only have one variable. X squared plus x plus 1 squared is equal to 25. We know how to solve such an equation of degree 2, and we find as solutions x equals 3 and x equals minus 4. Each of these solutions leads to another, simpler system of equations. Now substituting x equals 3 in the equation y equals x plus 1, we find y equals 4. And in the same way, substituting x equals minus 4 gives y is equal to minus 3. Now we found the coordinates of both points of intersection. Let's now consider the following situation. We have a stack of coins consisting of two different types of coins, say silver and gold. The height of the stack is 8 centimeters. We know that the silver coin has a thickness of 0.3 centimeters and a gold coin has a thickness of 0.2 centimeters. If x is the number of silver coins and y is the number of gold coins, then we have the equation 0.3 times x plus 0.2 times y equals 8. To make the equation look nicer, we multiply it by 10. So 3x plus 2y is equal to 80. We also weighted the coins, and the weight of the stack is 450 grams. Now a silver coin weighs 20 grams and a gold coin weighs 10 grams, so we have the equation 20x plus 10y equals 450. In this case, we divide by 10 to make the equation look nicer. The question is, of course, how many silver and how many gold coins have we got here? The answer is obtained by solving this system of equations. In the previous example, with the line and the circle, the first equation was of the form y is equal to a function of x, and we could substitute this into the second equation. Here we can do something similar. We first solve the second equation for y, which gives y equals 45 minus 2x, and then substitute into the first one. This gives us an equation in only one variable. Expanding the brackets, we obtain 90 minus x equals 80. Solving this gives the solution x equals 10, and putting this back into the equation y equals 45 minus 2x, we see that y equals 25. So we have 10 silver coins and 25 gold ones. The system of equations in this example also has a graphical interpretation. The equation 3x plus 2y equals 80 defines a line, namely the graph y equals 80 minus 3x divided by 2, the blue line here. The equation 2x plus y equals 45 defines the green line, which is the graph y equals 45 minus 2x. The solution that we found is the point of intersection of these two lines. We just solved two systems of equations using the substitution method. Solve the simplest of the two equations for y, substitute the expression for y into the second equation to obtain an equation only in x. Then solve this equation for x and substitute the result in the expression for y. Instead of first solving for y, you can also first solve for x. The substitution method is usually a good method to solve a system of two equations in two variables. However, the following example shows that you should be very careful with this method. Suppose we want to solve this system of equations. X times y equals 2x and x squared plus y squared equals 1. We solve the first equation for y, which gives y equals 2. Substituting this into the second equation leads to x squared plus 2 squared equals 1, and we conclude that there are no solutions. But actually, we missed a solution. Plug x equals 0 and y equals 1 into both equations to see that this is a solution to the system. So, why did we miss this solution? This is because the equation xy equals 2x has solutions y is equal to 2 and x is equal to 0. Plugging x equals 0 into the other equation gives y squared equals 1, so that y equals plus 1 or minus 1. So our system of equations has two solutions, x equals 0 and y equals 1, and x equals 0 and y equals minus 1. The substitution method can also be used for systems of three or more equations with three or more variables, but this is often much work.